It was in the time when the Lord spoke to his people in Israel through the mouth of the prophets. And in those days the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and the Lord regretted that he had made him king over Israel. And the Lord said unto his prophet Samuel, Arise, Samuel, fill your horn with oil, and go unto Jesse the Bethlehemite, for I have provided me a king among his sons. And Samuel came to Bethlehem, where David was tending his flocks and singing in the field. Jesse made seven of his sons to pass before Samuel, and they were fair and stalwart. And he thought, Surely the Lord's anointed is before him. But Samuel said unto Jesse, The Lord has not chosen these. Are here all thy sons? And he said, There remains yet the youngest, but he tends the sheep. Samuel said, Send and fetch him, for we will not sit down till he comes. And they sent and brought him in. And the Lord said, Arise, anoint him, for this is he. And the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon David from that day forward. And Saul and the men of Israel were gathered together and went to battle against the Philistines. David smote him in in the forehead with a stone from his sling. The Israelites rejoiced. With a spear at his hand, and he thought, I will pin David to the wall. And he cast the spear, but David eluded him, so that the spear struck into the wall, and David escaped and fled. David bade farewell to Jonathan, the son of Saul, whose soul was knit with the soul of David, for Jonathan loved him as his brother. And he came to Samuel and told him all that Saul had done. And he and Samuel went and dwelt at Naioth with the prophets in the wilderness. And the flower of his youth withered in the swelter of the desert.
Oh, had I wings of air,
And Saul sent messengers to take David. And they came to Naioth in Ramah, and they found him with Samuel and with the company of the prophets prophesying. Again David fled and wandered in the wilderness, and everyone that was in distress, and everyone that was in doubt, and everyone that was discontented gathered unto him. And now Samuel died, and the soul of David languished.
Refuge and harbor I seek, my rise. O sun, arise to lead me on, that with my heart the victory won. I bear it, I to sing, I bear it, I to sing, a joyful song of
chosen men out of all Israel, and went into the wilderness to seek David. But David sent out spies and learned that Saul had come and where he was encamped. And he stole into the camp of Saul by night and found where Saul lay sleeping, with his spear stuck in the ground at his head, and with all his army around him. Then said David's servant, God has given your enemy into your hand. Now let me pin him to the earth with one stroke of the spear, and I will not strike him twice. But David said, as the Lord lives, the Lord will smite him, and the Lord forbid that I should strike his anointed. So David took the spear and the cruse of water from Saul's bolster, and they went away, and no man saw it or knew it, neither did any awake. There was a deep sleep from the Lord has fallen. David said in his heart, I shall now perish one day by the hand of Saul. There is nothing for me but that I should escape to the land of the Philistines. So David arose and sent over, and his men with him, and together with the Philistines gathered their forces for war against Israel. And when the armies of Saul returned to fight the Philistines, they found themselves sore distressed in the mountain gorges. In vain the people of Israel called upon the Lord. When Saul had seen the host of the Philistines, he was afraid, and his heart trembled greatly. When he inquired of the Lord answered him not, neither by dreams nor by prophets. And his servant said unto him, there is a woman that hath a spirit at Endor. So Saul disguised himself, and came to the woman by night, and said, divine for me, and bring up whomever I shall name to thee. And the woman said, whom shall I bring up? He said, bring me up Samuel.
Oh,
Gilboa! Gilboa! The beauty of Israel is slain upon thy high places. How are the mighty fallen? Tell it not in Gath, publish it not in the streets of Ascalon, lest the daughters of the Philistines rejoice. Ye mountains of Gilboa, let there be no dew, neither let there be rain upon you, nor fields of offerings. For there the shield of the mighty is vilely cast away. The shield of Saul, as though he had not been anointed with oil, from the blood of the slain, from the fat of the mighty. The bow of Jonathan turned not back, and the sword of Saul returned not empty. Saul and Jonathan were lovely and pleasant in their lives, and in their death they were not divided. They were swifter than eagles. They were stronger than lions. Ye daughters of Israel, weep over Saul, who clothed you in scarlet with other delights, who put on ornaments of gold upon your apparel. How the mighty are fallen in the midst of battle. O Jonathan, thou wast slain in thy high places. I am distressed for thee, my brother, Jonathan. Very pleasant hast thou been unto me. Thy love was to me wonderful, passing the love of women. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the Lord has triumphed. David is king. God hath delivered thee to raise the tabernacle. He hath chose thee to cherish the ark of the God. Behold, it shall be set in the midst of Israel.
Thank you.
the shepherds bring their flocks, and the workers in the fields their harvest, and wine from the vineyards. And all the artisans have worked for the glory of God.
Oh,
And the Lord blessed David. The Lord gave him victory wherever he went. And David reigned over all Israel. He administered justice and equity to all his people. All the kings of the earth were his allies, and he was great among the great. But it happened late one afternoon, when David arose from his couch and walked upon the roof of the king's house, that he saw from the roof a woman bathing. And the woman was very beautiful. David sent and inquired about the woman. And one said, "Is that not Bathsheba, the wife of Uriah the Hittite?" So David sent messengers and took her, and she came to him, and he lay with her. Then she returned to her house, and the woman conceived. And she sent and told David, "I am with child." And David had Bathsheba's husband killed by sending him into the forefront of the battle. When Bathsheba's mourning was over, David sent and brought her to his house, and she became one of his wives and bore him a son. But the thing that David had done displeased the Lord, and the Lord struck the child, and it became sick. And on the seventh day, the child died.
Thank you.
the Lord sent Nathan to David to reprove him for his sin. And David felt the weight of his sin and fell into deep despair. And a brother killed his brother, and even Absalom, David's dearest beloved son, rose up against his father. The conspiracy grew strong, and the people with Absalom kept increasing. And one day a messenger came to David saying, "The hearts of the people have gone after Absalom." Then David called his servants and said, "Arise and let us flee, or else there will be no escape." And all the country wept as the people passed by, and the king crossed the brook Kedron and passed on towards the wilderness.
Oh, shall I raise my eyes unto the should come my help? The Lord shall guide thy steps, going and coming, from henceforth evermore. Be not suffer thy foot to be moved, for he above. The Lord who is thy keeper, none
Absalom pursued David with all the armies of Israel, and David mustered the men who were with him, and he sent them forth out into the field. But he said, deal gently for my sake with the young Absalom. And the battle was in the forest of Ephraim, and the men of Israel were defeated by the servants of David, and the slaughter was great. And Absalom was riding upon his mule, and the mule went under the thick branches of a great oak. And his hair caught fast in the oak, and he was left hanging between heaven and earth. And Joab chanced to pass by, and he took three darts in his hand and thrust them into the heart of Absalom while he was yet alive in the oak. And 10 young men surrounded Absalom and struck him and killed him. Chamber over the gate and wept. And as he wept, he said, oh, my son, Absalom, my son, would I had died instead of you. Oh, Absalom, my son, my son. And Joab came to the king and said, you have covered with shame the faces of all your servants who have this day saved your life, because you love those who hate you and hate those who love you. And I perceive that if Absalom were alive and all of us were dead, then would you be pleased. Now, therefore, arise, go out, and speak kindly to your people. For I swear by the Lord, if you do not go, not a man will stay with you this night. And this will be worse for you than all the evil that has pursued you from your youth until now. Then the king arose, took his seat in the gate, and his armies passed before him. David signaled with his hand, and the army stood still. And David said, "Ye warriors of Israel, ye are my brethren. Ye are my bones and my flesh. Ye have established peace in this land. Receive my thanks." Him from the hand of all his enemies. David waxed old in his palace of cedar and gold. And Satan stood up against Israel and provoked David to number the people. So the Lord sent pestilence upon Israel, and he sent an angel unto Jerusalem to destroy it. Advanced in years, and although they covered him with clothes, yet they could not make him warm. And he called to him Bathsheba, And she came into his chamber and stood before him. And he said, "As the Lord lives, who has redeemed my soul out of every adversity, as I swore to you by the Lord God of Israel, saying, Solomon, your son, shall reign after me and sit upon the throne in my stead." And David pronounced Solomon, the son of Bathsheba, king over Israel and over Judah. And when Nathan had crowned Solomon, David looked on the temple for the last time.
Sweet.